वेलकम टू वी लर्न वर्चुअल लर्निंग नेटवर्क. दिस इज सेशन नंबर 17, डेवलपिंग कॉग्निटिव एबिलिटीज एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग कॉन्सेप्ट्स. टॉपिक्स व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस सेशन आर सिंबॉलिक थॉट एंड फैंटेसी, सम कॉग्निटिव एबिलिटीज, एनिमिज्म एंड एक्वायरिंग कॉन्सेप्ट्स. So coming towards the introduction, the description of the emerging thinking abilities of the preschooler make for some of the most fascinating and interesting reading in the area of child development. Preschoolers are very serious about their reasoning and believe in their explanation through these may seem amusing to adults who look at the world differently. Moving towards the symbolic thought and fantasy. Once a child can think symbolically, she can also hold mental responsibilities of object and event. The picture these to help even when they are not present. Generally, agar hum bachchon ko symbolic form mein sikhate hain, suppose we show an apple and teach them, this is an apple. A is an apple. So it helps to memorize the things very easily and very frequently, and it create a long-term memory, a long-term impact of that picture in their mind. Learning language and drawing are other indicators which shows that the child is thinking symbolically. अगर हम बच्चों को सिंबॉलिकली बताते हैं तो वो एक लैंग्वेज लर्न करते हैं, उसके बाद उस पिक्चर को ड्रॉ करते हैं. अगर वो कुछ बोलते हैं उसके रिगार्डिंग या उसकी पिक्चर ड्रॉ करते हैं, देन वी कम टू नो दैट दे आर थिंकिंग सिंबॉलिकली. वो उसके बारे में सोच रहे हैं. हमने वन टाइम उन्हें टीच किया दैट इज एन एप्पल, दिस इज एप्पल, इट इज रेड इन कलर. तो बच्चे के माइंड में वो इम्पैक्ट रहेगा कि आई हैव सीन द पिक्चर दैट देयर इज एन एप्पल, इट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम लेटर ए एंड इट हैज रेड कलर, इट इज अ फ्रूट, इट इज एन ईटेबल. तो एक सिंबल शो करता है उस पर्टिकुलर पिक्चर के डिफरेंट करेक्टरिस्टिक्स, जो कि लॉन्ग टर्म किसी भी बच्चे के ब्रेन में रहते हैं. Learning language and drawing are other indicators which show that the child is thinking symbolically. In fact, language is the most widely used means of symbolic thinking. Preschoolers also narrate imaginary situations, stories to others. This is another aspect of make-believe. Generally, we observe that the school-going student or the preschoolers narrate their own created stories. They narrate the stories without any meaning. Why? Because they are relating different characters in those stories. Suppose if a baby says, if the teacher has taught the story of a lion and the wolf, so now there is the impact in the child's mind that there is a lion who lived in a jungle. He is a king of jungle, but he don't know what is next, what comes next. The teacher told me that there is a man who is passing by the jungle, he is a barber. So he relate the things that lion is very dangerous, so he will eat that particular man. So what does this? He is relating the pictures, he is relating his thoughts, he is narrating a story which has no meaning, which has no impact, which is not related to that means one thing is not related to the other, but they create a story. That is the imagination power. This is another aspect of make-believe. Some cognitive abilities. Taking another person's perspective. Cognitive ability means किसी के दूसरे की सिचुएशन को हम समझें, किस तरह से समझेंगे. मैचिंग, आइडेंटिफाइंग कॉमन रिलेशंस, कंजर्वेशन, classification and grouping. Serenation. Serenation is the ability to arrange items in terms of gradation of size, that is arranging things in order of increasing or decreasing size, understanding causing and effect relationships, that is the cognitive abilities. Through these abilities, child is always able to relate one another. Suppose he is able to know what is the relation of my father and my grandfather, what is the relation of my mother and grandmother. To cognitive abilities ke through common relationships ke bare mein usse pata chalta hai. Next is the conversation. Conversation means how to speak. Through his abilities, he know what to speak in front of his friends, what to speak in front of his parents, what to speak in front of the other members of the society. Next is classification and grouping. This is basically done in case of his friends, teachers and family. He classified his teammates or his age mates as his friends, whereas the person who are there in his family, in his house, he classified them as his parents, whereas anybody else who met him outside the family, he will consider him as a teacher. Next is the animism. Everything is living. The stone, the bridge, the road, the cloud, the sun, the moon, the table and the pencil. Preschooler feels that the stone will get hurt and feel pain if you kick it. 8. The bridge. Get tired in the night because so many things move over it during the day. Generally, bachche ye sochte hain ki agar hum kisi cheez ko marenge to unhe lag jayegi. Because they feel that everything is living. Everything has some pain, has some feeling. तो वो उन्हें distinction करना नहीं आता, उन्हें बस ये पता है कि जो भी हमारी surrounding में, हमारे environment में, जो भी material है, जो भी products हैं, वो living हैं. Whether they are stone, bridge, road or what else, they feel that they are alive. उन्हें लगता है कि ब्रिज थक गया है बिकॉज रात को उसको सोना है. बिकॉज देयर इज अ माइंडसेट दैट ड्यूरिंग नाइट वी ऑल हैव टू स्लीप. तो उनको ये लगता है कि रात को ब्रिज भी सो जाते हैं क्योंकि सारा दिन तो उनके ऊपर से व्हीकल्स जो है वो मूव कर रहे हैं, तो वो भी थक गया है. ही ऑल्सो हैव टू स्लीप. पाइगेट कॉल दिस क्वालिटी ऑफ देयर थॉट्स एमिनिज्म. उनकी इसी थॉट को एनिमिज्म कहा जाता है. एवरीथिंग हैज अ मैजिकल क्वालिटी अबाउट इट. हर किसी के पास अपनी एक मैजिकल क्वालिटी है जो कि हर इंडिविजुअल की डिफरेंट होती है. प्री स्कूलर्स हैव देयर ओन व्यूज एंड एक्सप्लेनेशन अबाउट थिंग्स. जनरली प्री स्कूलर्स के अपनी ही थॉट्स हैं, अपनी ही एक्सप्लेनेशंस हैं. This make interacting with preschoolers all the more interesting. उनके अपने ही views हैं, उनके अपनी ही mindset है, जो कि उनकी उनसे interaction एक बहुत ही interactive session बनाती है. उनसे बात करना हमें अच्छा लगता है. Why? Because we like their company, we like their talks. Next are the acquiring concepts. At this time, the preschool child is learning many new concepts and increasing her store of information, concept of number and other concept. Preschool time पे बच्चा और भी बहुत सी बातें सीखता है, जैसे कि number concept, that is what is 1, 2, 3, counting, how to count, how to read, what is 1, what is 2, so he gets the learning of these numbers. Whereas other concepts, what is the basic structure of the body, what are animals, what are living things, what are non-living things, so that all is taught in the preschool stage. Kahan pe क्या अप्लाई करना है, कलर्स आइडेंटिफाई करने हैं बच्चों को, डोमेस्टिक एनिमल्स और फार्म एनिमल्स के बीच में डिस्टिंक्शन बताना है, फ्लावर्स बताने हैं, डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फ्लावर्स, नेशनल बर्ड, नेशनल एनिमल, नेशनल फ्लैग, नेशनल एंथम. तो ये सब बेसिक कंसेप्ट्स हैं जो बच्चा अपने प्री स्कूल लाइफ में ही सीखता है. सो कमिंग टुवर्ड्स द कंसेप्ट ऑफ नंबर, If you ask 3 years old to pick up one subject, they will do so correctly and they are not likely to be able to pick up two objects when asked to do so. But ask them to pick up 5 pebbles and most of them will not be able to pick up the correct number, the amount varying each time. Between 4 and 5 years of age, children can recite numbers correctly from 1 to 10 and those who have been taught can also recite number names beyond. Generally, initial level पे जो 3 साल का बच्चा है उसे 1 और 2 का concept पता है. But if we ask a large number, if we ask them to pick up 5 pebbles or 10 pebbles, he is not able to pick because initially उसे concept ही नहीं पता, उसे number ही नहीं पता है कि what is 1, what is 2, what is 3, what is 5 and what is 10. What is the difference between these numbers? But if we come to age 4 and 5, तो वहां पे बच्चों को हम सिखाते हैं कि what is number 1, what is the meaning of 1 and what is the meaning of 10. तो basically child वहां पे 1 to 10 numbers recite करता है, उन्हें meaning पता है और number के साथ साथ वो उनके names भी बताता है. Other concepts. It is important to emphasize that children learn by doing, which means that they develop a concept of those things and events which they have experienced. All preschoolers will have experience with things that are heavy or light in weight, tall or short in height, narrow or wide, thick or thin, fast or slow in movement, light or dark in color, and they develop the concept of these. Preschoolers also develop an understanding of shape and size. People interest children greatly. Through interactions with them, children learn about relationship. The concept of time in all its dimension is a difficult thing for the preschooler to grasp. Now, coming towards the different concept. Different concept, bachon ko kya pata hoga? Height. If we are small, if we are tall, if we are thin, we are fat, we are fast, slow. So these are the pre-number concepts which are taught at the preschool age so that a child is able to differentiate between those things. What is heavy? What is light? So it is the concept which is taught at the preschool age. The emerging reasoning skills. Preschoolers are filled with curiosity and wonder about the things around them and have a burning desire to learn. In the process of finding out about things, they develop a wide variety of cognitive skills. Preschoolers learn about things around them in the course of their conversation, activities, and interaction with others. Preschool children can reason about everyday problems, giving you a number of alternative possibilities, some of which may bring a smile to your face. Now in the last, there are a few questions which are based on this session. What do you mean by animism? And number 2, what are the 4 aspects that are involved in forming the concept of number? That's all for this session. Thank you. Happy learning. We learning.